Alright guys, we're back for another Dokkan Battle video, and here we have Buu Piccolo. Now, Buu Piccolo is a ridiculous beast of a monster who came out during the Worldwide Download Celebration. At the time I'm starting this video, I actually still do not have full copies of him, but that's not a big deal because, you know, obviously I sometimes record some of these Rainbow Showcases and stuff like that in segments, right? What I want to do right now is I actually want to Dokkan Awaken him. And then I'm going to begin link leveling him, right? So that way, by the time I get the final copies, I could just, you know, finish out this Rainbow Showcase. Because, of course, you don't want to begin link leveling a character before you Dokkan Awaken them. Because once they Dokkan Awaken, some of their links can change or they'll gain links, right? For example, Buu Piccolo gains Fierce Battle once we Dokkan Awaken him. So, all right, I will continue this video now. Once I have the remaining dupes for him, we can put the Rainbow Star on him, and then we'll go ahead and test him out. He, of course, this Buu Piccolo is a tremendous powerhouse of a unit. All right, so we got our boy AGL Buu Piccolo rainbowed. All dupes, finally! That LR Turles banner came in clutch. So clutch that I needed two copies, but I actually pulled three copies from that STR Turles banner. So let's go ahead and put the Rainbow Star on Buu Piccolo. Again, I need to make sure that his link levels are at least at an acceptable, you know, like 5 range before we hop into a rainbow video for our boy Buu Piccolo. Eventually, I'm definitely going to work on getting him to full level 10 links as well, because this Buu Piccolo is nasty, disgusting, ridiculous, insane, powerful, and he's on a bunch of good categories, and he's a great option, and he's good for Super Battle Road. He is very, very good. So we're gonna do the rainbow video, probably like link level 5, something like that's usually what I aim for, and then eventually I'll do a full level 10 showcase for this guy as well, because he's just that damn good. All right, so we're here in an event. We will go ahead and start off on the Majin Power / Power Absorption team. Of course, you know, we'll go ahead and, you know, let LR Buu Tanks lead this team. We'll be able to get our boy Physical Kid Buu on here, because remember, for some reason, Kid Buu is not on Power Absorption. It is, I mean, I guess, because it, see, here's why I think it's kind of odd that Kid Buu is not on Power Absorption, is because he literally does absorb, West Supreme Kai, or South Supreme Kai, right? Like, he literally absorbs him. So I feel like that, you could put him on the category. Like, I guess, I don't know, because, like, First Form Cell is on there. It's odd. I just feel like you could put him on, but whatever. I guess it's not really that big of a deal. All right, so we'll go ahead and put Kid Buu first here. I don't think he'll get rid of this Vegito. Let's see what Buu Piccolo's, 181k, you say? I mean, I guess that makes sense, right? Because Buu Piccolo, here's his links. His, like, passive is so critical. Like, Tien is super good. Like, we all know how good Tien is, but Buu Piccolo is... Recover 15% HP at the start of turn, 3 key and 150% attack and defense. So giving himself key there is amazing considering everything else he does. Then power absorption category allies, 30% attack, 50% defense. And he also has a medium chance of evading enemy attack. It's a 25% chance. So Buu Piccolo essentially at the start of turn is getting 200% defense and 180% attack. So obviously he's pretty good. Now, his stats aren't the most crazy of all time, right? Like, he has about 10,000 exactly defense. Then his attack stat is only 13,000. I mean, there he is 2 million turn 1, which, I mean, is fine, considering he's also got the high chance of stunning. He's got the powerful support he's giving. He's got the chance of dodging. He heals at the start of turn. Like, he does a lot. You know, he's got the Metamorphosis link as well, which is another healing link. So, you know, you put this guy next to LR Buu Tanks, right? And it's like... That rotation is insane, because Buu Tanks heals, what, like 12% HP? So that's like 27% HP at the start of turn, and then Metamorphosis will give you another 10%. So that's like, what, 37% HP? That is what Buu Tanks does, right? 12%? Yep, 12%. So they heal 37% HP at the start of turn together, Buu Tanks and Buu Piccolo. I mean, obviously, that, again, that's good. that's a strong number right there. So, you know, they did a really good job with the link level update. To make the Buu units, like, super good, right? And I did sort of theorize. I thought the link level update LR Bootanks, I think, was one reason why they did the link level update. Like he had to have been a factor there. I mean, there's definitely more to it. But, like, villains in general, I feel, made up major ground on hero units with the link level update. So it's badly needed for the game. Look at when they introduced Super 17 into the game, and they fundamentally changed how the game worked, right? Before, remember, like, defensive stacking and all these types of abilities, they only worked for that phase. Like right now we're fighting this Int Blue Vegito right now. Defensive stacking would only last while we're fighting this Int Blue Vegito. When he goes to the next phase, all that shit would be reset. That's the way the game used to work before Super 17 came out, right? So then they also added every super attack is then either a blast or a physical attack, like right here, right? So like Bootanks' 12 key and 18 key, they're both physical. Okay, I think Boo Piccolo, his is a blast, isn't it? I think it is. Or maybe it's not. Let's skip Kid Buu. Yeah, Kid Buu is a blast. Boo Piccolo has a physical attack. Bootanks has a physical attack. Buff Boo is a physical. See, like, you just go through and all these characters have all these different, like, attacks and stuff like that. It's because the game was just changed so much when Super 17 was introduced, right? Okay, so, yeah, there is, again, Boo Piccolo, like, 180k, just very, very good. Bootanks can get one attack. I don't think he'll one-shot this Vegito if I don't go all the way with his key. But, I mean, if Bootanks doubles or triple supers, it's going to be GG for Vegito here. Let's see. That's a big attack set. All right, let's see how much damage Bootanks will do right here. I mean, ooh, boy. Okay, we got an additional. Don't do another one. Okay, we're good. Now, one issue for Boo Piccolo that I do think could crop up. I mean, it's not really a big deal, right? But he does have links like Demonic Ways and Brainiacs, which you're not really going to have active on, I think, some of these teams you're using. Now, Demonic Ways, right? You could, I guess, on, like, Cooler's team, you could get that linked up with LR Demon King Piccolo. Or potentially Lord Slug, right? They're both on Terrifying Conquerors. Then, of course, you can combine that with the Transformation Boost, right? Brainiacs. Is there a unit that could actually get Brainiacs with this Boo Piccolo? Like one that's good that you'd actually run with him? Probably not. I mean, like, Seelus is on Transformation Boost. Not really. I mean, you could use Blue Vegito does have it, at least in base, right? But probably not something you're going to see. Let's have Bootanks do his transformation. We'll let him get an attack set, and then we'll probably move on to the next team, right? Boo Piccolo is on several different category teams. What is he on? Five different teams. Some of them being really good. You know, Majin Buu Saga is definitely one of the best teams in the game now. Transformation Boost, we know how good that is. Right, Majin Power, Artificial Life Form, Power Absorption. They're all sort of intertwined between LR Bootanks and then, of course, the Exchange Majin Buu's leader skills, right? Alright, so we'll go ahead and let Buhan do that. And then we'll let this Buhan do that, and then we will go ahead and finish up. Let's see how much damage the two Buhans can do. I think this LR Buhan right here, the friend one, I think he's at 55%, I believe. I'd have to go ahead and double check that. One cool thing about these new Dokkan Fest bosses is, you know, when they super you, you do get to see the amazing animations, right? Like, that's, you know, because if you go fight one of the old bosses, you know, they're using all the old animations. That's the other thing, like, any Dokkan Fest event that hasn't had a new one in a while could easily, like, you know, Kid Buu needs a new stage to his Dokkan event. Like, that's why everyone was so upset about, like, no LR for part two. But it's like, I mean, he's a character, he needs a new Dokkan event. Like, that's definitely a Dokkan event character, 100%. 3.26 for Buff Boo, by the way, with no support. Yeah, Buff Boo is pretty, that boy is pretty good. I'm just saying. All right, now we're over here on the Majin Power / Artificial Life Form team. 150k without any extra support, huh? Wow, this Boo Piccolo is really a ferocious unit. He is so good. Like, again, that's 150k. He's not getting support, but he's also got the healing. He's got the dodging. Like, he's doing so much. Like, it is stunning to me how good they made him, honestly. Like, both him and the Bootanks, I mean, all four of those summonable units were just, like, beyond belief, right? Bootanks, Tien, SCR Vegito, and then the Bootanks / Buhan are just, like, all so insane. Because it's like, Yeah, then we see Boo Piccolo also has that high chance of stunning on there too, man. Like, there's a lot that this boy does. I am a big time fan. Here, let me try and I try and do like a variety of Dokkan events, but it's just like impossible to like not destroy, not just incinerate these Dokkan events just so fast, right? We'll go ahead and get Rildo again. Artificial life form, one of the reasons it is my favorite is because you have like the 50% supports on there, which like some support type units like Kid Buu, right? Kid Buu is not really, wow, 2.57 metal cooler, that's pretty good because he's not Link leveled up that much at all. And then also his passive is not built up either. Yeah, right there. I mean, he was getting 100% support, but still decent attack stat from metal cooler right there. Again, there's so many units I want to see Link level 10 getting them up there and then sort of, you know, being able to play around with them. But, you know, it takes a long time to Link level 10 characters. Like, just before starting recording on this, I just finished up my Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta. So, Gogeta took me 7, 8, 9 days of nearly nonstop grinding to get full Link level 10s, right? That's my Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta. Like, that's just the amount of time it takes sometimes for some of these characters, so... All right, I'm curious about this. So this is Boo Piccolo, still basically at 140k defense. This is him with only one Link. Oh, good, the cord. Yes, cord. There we go. That's what we came to see. This is what we came to see, the cord issues, huh? Thank you, cord, so much. All right, well, let's see what Boo Piccolo is capable of doing right here as far as attack set. So this has actually worked out pretty well because I do like seeing what the units can do sort of drenched in support, but I also want... like rotations where we don't have a million support type units and then we have one support. Like I just try and get a variety of different situations here in different teams. And a lot of times I try and build at least semi-realistic teams, but sometimes I like building sort of an oddball team as well, right? Especially like keeping support away. Because like, you know, every unit pretty much now is going to look really good when you have physical Kid Buu sitting next to them and, you know, you got one of the 50% supports and all that shit. Like they're all going to look good, but... it's like a lot of times in Super Battle Road, you know, you're not like in Super Battle Road, if it comes to physical Kid Buu or Int Kid Buu, you're probably gonna run Int Kid Buu, right? Like I just would assume he's definitely a little bit better there. But at the same time, I did want to get Rildo, Kid Buu, and Buu Piccolo together. So I guess I'm gonna get this attack stat from Skinny Buu right here. Actually, hold on, no. I'm gonna let this turn play out right here. I want to get Boo Piccolo with Rildo next turn, and then we're going to hop back in with the same team, and I do want to get the Kid Buu, Rildo, and Boo Piccolo rotation. I want to see what Boo Piccolo will do in that situation, right? And then, of course, you know, Kid Buu is there to give him the basics, you know, wall standing tall, fierce battle, and Majin, right? Boo Piccolo, well, one good thing Boo Piccolo does have is Nightmare. Nightmare is going to work very well on Terrifying Conquerors. Oh, you're dead. Wow. Okay. I didn't... actually expect Gohan to get finished off right there. Okay, sure. All right, so now we are on artificial life forms again. I wanted to get that Boo Piccolo and Kid Buu and then also Rildo rotation. Let's go ahead and do this right here. Hopefully Kid Buu doesn't double super attack, do crazy things. We'll see. Boo Piccolo at 200k defense, obviously that's good. Now a big part of that, of course, is because Kid Buu is giving 50%, and then obviously Boo Kid Babidi is giving, what does he give, 40% when HP is 81% or more. 2.26 for Boo Piccolo, pretty good. And then of course we're gonna get an even better attack stat on this next rotation with Metal Rildo, right? Metal Rildo obviously is the 50% support for Extreme AGL, and that's gonna be really good. Remember, Boo Piccolo is gonna be an absolutely incredible like extreme Super Battle unit and stuff like that. Like he is going to look very, very impressive. That is absolutely for sure. All right, I don't know if the Skinny Boos are enough to take down this Goku here. Maybe. I mean, they are just going to super attack. Yeah. Okay. So they're super attacking, let's just go for it. One thing that is very annoying is when we're not able to, finish off one of these bosses like this, and then he's got, like, a sliver of health left. That's always the worst when going through these showcases. Yeah, that's, Skinny Buu does not exactly have a lot of links active with Super Mira. Okay. All right, well, okay, the opposite. We're barely going to do any damage to this Goku. Okay, perfect, perfect, perfect. So he'll have plenty of health that we'll be able to play around with on this next rotation. That's good. Okay, so let's see what Buu Piccolo's defense is on this rotation. Then, of course, the amount of damage he'll be able to do. Oh, there's a dodge from Skinny Buu. Okay. All right, so we are at a very high number. 198k. Actually, a little bit less than the turn where we had Boo Bobbity. That's because he had Metamorphosis, which is giving 10% defense on top. He also did have Nightmare. Nightmare and Metamorphosis, those two links is what the Boo Kid Bobbity had. Because we only have, what, Majin, Wall Standing Tall, and Fierce Battle with Kid Boo right there. Okay. So let's go ahead and get this rotation, and then we'll go ahead and move on probably to Transformation Boost, and then we'll finish up. So let's see what Buu Piccolo does right here on this rotation. And he gets up to a 2.33 million attack set. Goodbye, Goku. There's the dodging kicking in, and then he's got the support, and he's got the stun, and he's got the heal. Like, Buu Piccolo, he's a dirty boy. He's pretty good. All right, so now we're on Transformation Boost. Coolers, very fun team. This time I decided, why don't we bring Int Kid Buu, right? With his fresh, brand new EZA. See how powerful he will be alongside Buu Piccolo. The only thing about Buu Piccolo and Kid Buu as a rotation, obviously, again, is that Kid Buu is stupidly not on power absorption, and that's what Buu Piccolo is a support type unit for. Still 1.9 million attack stat right there. That's pretty good. I mean, obviously, Cooler is supporting Buu Piccolo, right? Cooler does give that transformation boost support type buff, which is good. Here's Kid Buu. Oh! Yeah. It's a soft 5 million right there. Very good. Yeah. Huh. So that's the thing. Like, it's like I'm doing showcases for other units. So, like, I have to, like, pretty much usually, like, I've got to use physical Kid Buu, right? And then we see shit like that. And it's just like, wow. That's something else, huh? that ain't Kid Buu, man. He is quite dynamic when it comes to damage. And, I mean, he's giving ki as well to Extreme Class. I mean, Int Kid Buu is super good. It's just, again, when it comes to showcases, obviously, physical Kid Buu is one you got to use. But, whew, boy, that is a, he is a bad boy. That's... So about how that goes. I'm actually going to leave Janemba on rotation right here. And then, obviously, Cooler. I don't have to worry about this Goku nuking us with the Spirit Bomb because we'll be able to instantly sit him down with Cooler, right? Cooler doesn't play these games. He's just going to say, goodbye, Goku. Honestly, even Janemba could just finish Goku off. He could, but he didn't. In Janemba, that's another character I want to get to Link level 10. Take a look at him because... You know, the one problem for Int Janemba really is just his lack of teams, but he is still extraordinary and outstanding. Maybe like a new LR Janemba or something like that could introduce a new category for Janemba. That would be sick. Okay, so there we go. Let's see. We are getting a couple extra links from Cooler. What are we getting? Does he have Metamorphosis and Nightmare? I think he does, because, well, the only two links we don't have active right now, yeah, are Demonic Ways and Brainiac. So this is actually a pretty good rotation right here. This would be a higher attack set for Buu Piccolo than we've seen, huh? Would be AGL Cooler, Buu Piccolo, and then Physical Kid Buu. But of course, it's not, come on, Physical Kid Buu. Oh, this guy, of course, always needs to be there to make everything else look good. AGL Cooler, remember, is also quite good. You know, he's giving, what is it, 40%, I believe, to AGL types. So that's going to be very, very good for our boy Buu Piccolo. Although AGL Cooler is not the greatest when it comes to defense. But he can do good damage as well with, you know, all of his built-in additionals and stuff like that. All right, so what is Buu Piccolo going to do right here? 2.19, obviously pretty good. And if he does not finish off Int UI Goku, I'm quite certain that Int Kid Buu probably will. With his 3.53 million attacks. Yeah, Int Kid Buu. I mean, he is, he's strong. Strong is the word I think I would use for that Int Kid Buu. Very, very powerful. So, okay, we're done here. Because we got the Coolers and we got Janemba. Yeah, this rotation is called GG. So, I guess we'll go ahead and move into our breakdown now. for our boy AGL Boo Piccolo. Power taken from others, Majin Buu Piccolo. His leader skill is Power Absorption category, key 3 and 120% of stats. His super attack is the Light Grenade, which does supreme damage with a high chance of stunning the enemy. His passive skill, Majin Scheme, has him recover 15% HP at the start of turn, which obviously is very good. Then he gets 3 key and 150% attack and defense at the start of turn. Then he gives Power Absorption category allies 30% attack and 50% defense. And then he has a medium chance of evading enemies' attack. The medium chance, of course, is a 25% chance. Now, I'm never really too crazy about, like, 25% chance to dodge, shit like that. But, I mean, considering Buu Piccolo also has, like, 150k defense and plus, like, you know, it's okay. You know, that dodge occasionally is going to dodge a super attack, a stray super here and there. So that's going to be pretty good. His links are Demonic Ways, Brainiacs, Metamorphosis, Majin, Nightmare, The Wall Standing Tall, and Fierce Battle, so that's good. His 12k multiplier is 140%, which is what we, you know, typically see from these types of units. And then finally, he is on a number of different category teams. He does have quite a few different category teams, actually. So here, of course, this is what, Power Absorption right here? Yeah, so Mira, the new Mira was just added to Power Absorption. That's interesting. Getting another unit added to that for the first time since the categories come out is good. Then he's also over here on the Majin Buu Saga team. We could have looked at him there. But, you know, running him on the Buu Saga team, things will look very similar to, like, Majin Power and stuff like that, right? Since it's just a bunch of Buus together. Although I could use, like, you know, Deborah or LR Bobbity and Deborah is very possible as well, because, you know, they work well with the Majin Buu units. Then, of course, he's also on Transformation Boost. We know exactly what this team is looking like. Most top-tier units end up on this category because, like, the transformation mechanic is just something they basically spam at us at this point. Yeah, I guess it is a little bit funny that SCR Vegito is not on here, huh? Yeah, probably. He probably should be on it, considering he does go Super Saiyan in his, like, fusion animation, right? Then, of course, Buu Piccolo is also over here on Artificial Life Form. Artificial Life Form is actually one of my favorite categories, and there's still a lot of room for improvement in the future as well, so that's good. And then finally, Buu is on the Majin Power category. We're probably pretty set on the Majin Power category for a while. Maybe Janemboo might get his Dokkan Awakening with the Dragon Ball Heroes collab coming up. And then obviously we are still waiting on a super top tier Kid Buu. I think Super Buu could get a better version of a character as well. But, you know, for a while we're probably going to be set for the Majin Power category. But, you know, we'll see what happens. Because this category itself just got such a massive overhaul from, what should we call it, the Link level update, right? So there's our boy Buu Piccolo. Let me know what you guys think. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch y'all next time.